Sherman's bill was a gruesome manifestation of white supremacy. The person I was talking with completely disagreed. Things then got heated and we started talking over each other. And then he said, "Can I finish, Simone? Will you shut up for a moment and let me finish? How do you get them to stop talking when they keep interrupting you?" Them? They? I'm standing right here. I have a right to have my voice heard. But sometimes when you're telling the truth and spitting facts, the powers that be try to shut you down. Not today. People want us to be respectful and let the seasoned adults handle this. This is for anyone who's been talked over, ignored, or dismissed. Racism is a persistent issue that affects everyone in this country. It manifests in various forms such as individual prejudices and systematic policies, which was made evident when the Affirmative Action Bill was repealed this past summer. You know, the bill that ensured access to education for all and promoted a more inclusive society. Now that's all gone. Because you guessed it, a white man in power. If we do not say something and confront these ideals, what other aspect of our humanity will be taken away? The fact that bills created to reduce discrimination are being thrown out is a constant reminder that despite all the progress we have made, there is still so much work to be done. No You Show by Simone D. Sanders. I grew up in Omaha, Nebraska. And when I was 13, I took part in a program called She Votes Through Grover. The program introduced girls to the political process, and that's how I found my passion for politics. About 6 years later, when I was in college, I got the chance to really know Washington. I started going back and forth from Omaha, and I found that Washington was where I needed to be. However, my first month in D.C. was miserable. I didn't have any money, and my job was hard. In other words, I was in my early 20s. I wasn't doing what I expected to, and I knew I had to make it work. So I went to interviews after interviews. Until finally, after 29 interviews, I found myself meeting with the director of the Bernie Sanders campaign. 3 weeks go by, crickets. Amidst all this, an annual conference was held. Around the time of Devin Sanders' way, as Bernie was addressing them, the activists started interrupting him by shouting out the name of Land, another black woman killed by the police. Bernie looked flustered and out of touch. Obviously, they called me a week later. It was kind of surreal meeting Bernie Sanders for the first time. Our conversation was something like this. I didn't know there were so many black people in Nebraska? I was going to say Democrats. Okay. After a while, we got into an argument about inequality. Instead of fighting back, I decided to tell him a story. One night when I was in college, I was driving home from the library when I got pulled over. "Ma'am, are you aware there is a warrant out for your arrest?" "A warrant? For what?" "As it turns out, I had a small number of parking tickets. Can I pay them now?" "No, ma'am, that's not how this works. We're going to have to take you to jail." While on the back of the police vehicle, I noticed there was another officer. I started telling him that I was a student at Creighton, thinking he'd let me go. No dice. Before we got to holding, one of the officers said, "Oh, by the way, we found your weed." I didn't say anything because I didn't hear them. "Did you hear me? We found your weed." I didn't know what to do. I knew that if I acted in any way that they saw as rash, that they would hurt me, or worse, I could be killed. For the next 30 minutes, they tried to convince me to take ownership of this marijuana that wasn't mine. They were trying to pin it on me. "Look, I swear, it's not my marijuana. There would be times that I would go to campaigns, specifically ones in certain areas. And I couldn't even get in. And this happened all the time because of racism! One particularly uncomfortable moment was during the rally of 2016. We had Secret Service. I had just bought this popular pea coat from Banana Republic, and things were going well. A bunch of our campaign staff went to address the 200 people that couldn't get in, while I introduced Bernie Sanders and stood off to the side with Paul, the senior advisor, who was also a tall black man. After Bernie was done addressing his speech, someone started yelling, "Ma'am, ma'am, move, move, get out of the way, move." I was like, "This boss, that lady, the governor, she gotta move." We need to commit radical.